your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. FootballSportsApp.com. What is it? It's the first live-action mobile sports app played in real time and a cool way to immerse yourself in the game. Make coaching calls just like the pros. Check out the video. Download for free this fall and register now again at FootballSportsApp.com. Want to be part of this new exciting technology and make money? Fill out the short form at the bottom of the website and mention TDSS. Again, FootballSportsApp.com. Yes, sir. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Woke up this morning. The great Jill Scott. We're paying homage to the great Jill Scott today for Woman Wednesday, which is my favorite day of the week. We still got to mention some WNBA. Shut up. Jill Scott grew up in North Philadelphia, raised by her mother, Joy Scott, and her grandmama. She indicated in an interview with Jet Magazine she had a happy childhood, felt very much loved. She was raised as a Jehovah's Witness. Damn, Jehovah's Witness came to my house yesterday morning, 7 a.m. And she attended the Philadelphia High School for Girls. After graduating from high school, she attended Temple University. Okay. While simultaneously working two jobs, she studied secondary education for 3 years and at one time planned to become a high school English teacher. Good Lord, I would never be able to concentrate if Jill Scott was my English teacher.
Hey, Miss Scott! Miss Scott, can you give me a hug?
Slam my face in between her bosoms. She studied secondary education for 3 years and at one time planned to become an English teacher. I read that. And however, after serving as a teacher's aide, she became disillusioned with the teaching job. Oh, yeah, because them churn bad as hell. Anybody would become disillusioned. And she dropped out of college. Prior to breaking through the music industry, Scott worked at a variety of jobs, including a number of retail positions and stints at a construction site and an ice cream parlor. Somebody, speaking of, she worked a couple of jobs, somebody email me. Not only do I need you to email me, you know, ways where we can get more followers to the Doug Stewart Show, email me if y'all know anybody hiring. I laugh so I don't cry. Yeah. And I'm not going to stop doing the show, but I do need to get a job at some point here. My wife keeps looking at me with an evil eye. When we first became unemployed, you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. We got to do birthdays here in a second. I would say, just as I said a little bit earlier, somebody said in the chat room, when we first got unemployed, my money was, I would say, long as train smoke. Not so much no more. Oh, I laugh so I don't cry. Praise his holy name. But seriously, though, I do need a job. Somebody email me if y'all company is hiring. I'm just joking. No, I'm serious. All right, celebrating his 36th birthday today is Toronto Blue Jays player Jose Bautista. Yeah. Remember Jose Bautista got decked in the mouth by the kid from, who that guy played for? His name was Odor? Was it Odor? Or something like that? From Texas. I think he played for the Texas Rangers. And punched Jose Bautista square in his mouth. That was some funny stuff. Celebrating his 64th birthday today is the great, and I do mean this when I say it, the great Floyd Mayweather Sr. Love that guy. Ew. Floyd Mayweather Sr. turned 64 years of age. You know we've interviewed that guy several times, man. Very, very funny dude. And people forget, and this young generation doesn't understand, but Floyd Mayweather Jr., or Floyd Mayweather Sr., who we're talking about here, was real nice with his hands back in the day. But not in one particular fight. I want you to YouTube Mayweather Sr. and Sugar Ray Leonard. Sugar Ray Leonard beat Floyd Mayweather Sr. an inch from his life. Floyd Sr. hung with him for a while, and then it all came crumbling down at the very end. Speaking of boxing, man, Evander Holyfield, the real deal Holyfield, turns 54 years old today. Happy birthday to Evander, the champ. ATL's finest. Happy birthday, Evander.
Happy birthday.
Celebrating his 71st birthday today is John Lithgow, character actor. He's been in a ton of movies. Just Google John Lithgow, and you'll see exactly who I'm talking about. He had a prominent role one season in Dexter. Just look up John Lithgow. I think it's Lithgow, or it might be Lithgow. He turned 71 years old today. And posthumously, man, he would have had a birthday today, but he died a long time ago. He died back in 1992. Robert Reed. You know who Robert Reed was? Robert Reed was Mike Brady. He played Mike Brady in the Brady Bunch. Rest in peace. Which clearly you're not resting right now. You basically worm food right now. You died back in 1992? Yeah. There's probably nothing much left. And also, one quick little entertainment story, man. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame announced the nominees for its 2017 class yesterday, with Pearl Jam and rapper Tupac Shakur heading the list. Wow. Tupac Shakur nominated for the 2017 class of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Other first-time nominees this year include Bad Brains. I don't know who the hell Bad Brains is. Da Peachy Mode, Electric Light Orchestra, Jane's Addiction, Joan Baez's Journey, and Steppenwolf. Rounding out the list of nominees are J. Gale's band, Chic. You remember Chic back in the day. Janet Jackson's nominated. Joe Tex, Kraftwerk. You know, Kraftwerk has been very prevalent over the last couple of years as from that dude, what's the dude's name, Pharrell. He's been sampling and using a lot of their music, doing a lot of stuff with them, Kraftwerk. MC5, The Cars, and The Zombies. Yeah, Tupac Shakur deserves to be in some type of Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, man. You're talking about a lasting legacy. Wow. Yeah, Tupac Shakur, man, nominated for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That's your birthdays. Oh, one quick last birthday. I already gave a shout-out to Vern from Jersey. Happy birthday, Vern from Jersey. And I saw in the chat room, man, today's my cousin's birthday, man. Happy birthday to Gilliard Road. Yeah. Yeah, happy birthday to my cousin Gilliard Road. I'm not going to say his name. Maybe he don't want people to give out his government name because, you know, maybe he's got some warrants or something out there for his arrest. But happy birthday, cousin. Let me read a couple of messages in the chat room on Spreaker.com. From RC, Evander's going into the Boxing Hall of Fame next year. He finally retired 5 years ago, so he'll be a slam dunk Hall of Famer. I agree. Man, I really, you know, I got like a love-hate with Orlando, with Evander. Who the hell is Orlando? I got kind of I had kind of like a love-hate relationship with Evander. One, he was from ATL, so, you know, everybody from ATL that does it big on a national level, I got much love for him and respect. But Mike Tyson probably was my favorite boxer of all times. And the way that Evander went in there and was not scared of Mike Tyson, I didn't like that. I got to be honest with you. Like, literally, when Holyfield and Tyson fought that first time, like, after the first couple of rounds, when it was clearly evident that Evander wasn't scared of Mike Tyson, like, in my mind, I was saying, how dare this guy not be scared of Mike Tyson? Oh, man. I mean, the champ, when I'm talking about Holyfield now, the champ went blow for blow. Like, I don't think he backed up at all. Like, not one iota in that first fight with Mike Tyson. Like, literally, it looked like that he had in his mind that he was tied to Mike Tyson and everybody jockeying Mike Tyson, and he was going to show him. And, man, I was the biggest Tyson fan in the world, I'm telling you. Tyson and Roy Jones probably, if I want to go back to old school, I would say Sugar Ray Leonard as well. Sugar Ray Leonard, Mike Tyson, and Roy Jones Jr., probably my three favorite fighters of all time. Much love for Ali, but when Ali fought, you know, when I remember Ali fighting, he was at the end of his career, and he was getting jabbed to death by Larry Holmes and all like that. So I don't have the same feeling, but those three, them was my dudes. And, man, Evander Holyfield literally came in there and punked Mike Tyson. Bitch, I ain't scared of you. That was crazy. Oh, yeah, and he was headbutting. My man, Bat Ninja, says Holyfield headbutted every time that Mike Tyson got close to him. That was another thing I didn't like either. And once again, I was a Tyson fan. So, one, the gall of him coming in there and not being scared of Tyson. Clearly, he wasn't. And two, he was headbutting the hell out of Tyson, which is true. And everybody says, well, that was an excuse. That wasn't no excuse. Evander Holyfield was dropping that big milk dud head of his on Mike Tyson every single time Tyson came in. That's true. From Grego X Squad, I was so mad at Holyfield. I was too. And I think that was kind of like a theme that, man, Mike Tyson, and for the younger people that are listening to this show right now, they have no clue. Mike Tyson was literally like walking death. Like, if you look at Tyson's first like 20 fights, they were all scared in their boots. Like, everybody, when that bell rung in the first round, man, the fight was over. Because of the vicious knockouts that Tyson had preceding that particular fight, like, these cats knew that they were basically walking the green mile. They were about to get knocked the F out. And then he had that fight with Holyfield, man, and all of the invincibility just, like, went away. You know, and you know what happened, obviously, with Buster Douglas. And then Lennox Lewis came in there and act like he wasn't scared of him. Like, the whole invincibility thing of Mike Tyson was just out of the window after those couple of fights right there, man. Man, those were the great old days. You talk about getting hyped up. The only thing I get more hyped up than for homecoming is a championship fight. And probably I've never been more hyped up, geeked up about watching a fight is when Mike Tyson fought on Saturday night, man. Wow. Wow. Memories. When we get back from the break, man, I'm going to talk about quickly this Tim Tebow story. Baseball ain't a sport either. Maybe it's horseshoes. Maybe Tim Tebow is going to get on the horseshoe circuit here next. Back in 3 minutes, the Doug Stewart Show.
Ladies, have you been experiencing tough times lately? Is your man not eating the potato salad the way he used to? Things a little stressful at work? Well, I'm sure your girls have told you that there's a new spot in town. So come on over, to SME After Dark and allow me, Christopher Tracy, and the Honorable Deacon